Hi guys, so today I'm going to be doing this look right here. It's just a very neutral, wearable look that you could wear every day to work or to school. And I'm also going to be focusing on just long-lasting tips. So this is a long-lasting foundation routine. If you want a face that's going to stay all day, watch this video. And then also I'm just going to do a quick eye tutorial on just a simple eye. No lashes, no glitter, no pink, no green, none of that. So if you are interested in seeing this, just keep on watching and we'll just dive right in. So I've already moisturized my face with my Philosophy Miracle Worker Oil-Free Miraculous Anti-Aging Lotion. I also have a little bit of this eye cream. This is just the Origins Plant Scription Eye Cream just underneath my eyes because I am going to be using Max Pro Longwear Concealer because it is very long lasting, but it does tend to make the under part of your eye here a little bit dry, so a little extra moisture helps with that. So to get started, I like to go in with this primer here. This is Basha. I don't know how you pronounce it. Basha, I think. No pores, no shine. T-zone treatment. And I like to just get a little pea-sized amount, about that much. And I'm just gonna dab this just in my T-zone where it gets nice and oily. So just rub it in. Rub it all in there. So there we go, and now we got the primer on, a moisturizer on. That is really important to get your kind of base set so your makeup can really stick on there and just last all day. Next, I'm gonna go in with this Tarte Amazonian Full Coverage Clay Foundation. I am in the shade Tan Deep Sand, and I'm gonna go in with this brush here. This is just the famous F80 Kabuki brush from Sigma. So I love this. This is just pretty full coverage, and this lasts all day, I swear. Like, I wear this to go to Valley Fair. If you're from Minnesota, you know what that is. It's just an amusement park. It's kind of a water park too. I went to the State Fair with this on, and this foundation, it did me good. Like, I love this guy. So we're gonna go ahead and put this on. Just about that much there. So I'll just show you how full coverage this is. I'll just do one side of my face and then I'll buff in the other side. We're just gonna use this brush and just buff it in. Just kind of press it into the face. So you can see how that's just covering everything up and completely changing my skin tone. So do you see that difference from this side to this side with that big goop hanging off? But yeah, so now I'll just go in and work this in. So you can see that my foundation really evened out my skin tone. So if you're looking for a really good foundation, I love the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation, so try it out if you haven't already. Now we're gonna go in with Max Pro Longwear Concealer. I am in shade NC25. This stuff is really long lasting. Like I said before, the only con is that it does kind of dry out the underside of your eyes. So look, I am just using that much. It's just a tiny little bit, because this stuff goes a long way. I know it's a small bottle, but I mean, I've had this for a long time, and look, it's like only a third gone, maybe? So we're just gonna dab this under our eyes, in all the usual places. And we can just use the brush to buff out the rough edges. So now you got your concealer on, now we just gotta set it. So this is my Wet n Wild, Reserve Your Cabana. I dropped it. I dropped a lot of stuff, and so I broke. But I'm just gonna take my tapered brush here and just set the underside of my eye. Just so it doesn't crease. And I'll just set that other concealer. Now you definitely want to set the rest of your face. So I'm just gonna go in with Sephora's, 8-Hour Wear Mattifying Compact Foundation Powder. So again, this is meant for long wear. I don't even deal with anything that doesn't say it's long wear. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this guy here and just set the rest of my face. Next step, we just gotta go in there and contour, blush, all of that. I'm just gonna go in with this Estee Lauder Bronze Goddess. It is just the most gorgeous bronzer. I love this bronzer so much. And I'll do one side with this, and I'll show you a dupe for this. I swear it's a dupe. This is really expensive, so that kind of sucks. but I do have a dupe. No, put that on the other side. I swear you won't be able to tell the difference. So here we go, just contouring a little bit, not too much, because we're not gonna do like a dramatic. Whoops. We're not gonna do like a super dramatic like night look. So just a little bit of contouring. And here I'm gonna go on the other side with this Wet n Wild. So it's like $4, I think. We're gonna go on with this Wet n Wild bronzer. And this is called Bikini Contest. And I swear this is like exactly the same, guys. Let's see. I mean, do you see it has the same warmth and depth? I love it. I can't tell the difference. I don't know about you guys. Since we are doing long-lasting makeup, I'm going to be using Tarte's blush. Tarte is just such a high-quality blush, and they are called the Amazonian Clay 12-Hour Blush, and they do last a long time. But today I'm going to go in with this color here, and this is called Captivating. It's just a gorgeous kind of peachy, nudie kind of color. For a highlight, I'm going to be going in with MAC Fairly Precious Mineralized Skin Finish. Just dip my fan brush in there and just glide this right on the high points of your cheeks. Just give it a little shimmer, maybe your nose if you want, and wherever. I just did everything. So that's done. So your face is basically done for now. Now I'm going to go and do my brows real quick. Oh my gosh, you guys, it is such a struggle to do my brows now. I didn't even film it. Trying to match the color of my hair to my brows. It's so hard. I just dyed it last night and I did a wash of magenta, so I'm turning from red to magenta, and so it's like brown script, what I've been using to film my brows, just isn't cutting it anymore. So I don't know, I kind of experimented, so now they're like really red. But they'll work for today, right? I hope they do. So moving on, we got our face basically done. I'm just gonna throw in a little bit of contouring on my nose, super, super quick. And I'm just gonna go in with this Too Faced bronzer, Chocolate Soleil. Oh, it smells so good. I love contouring my nose with it because all I smell is chocolate. So I'm just gonna use just a little e.l.f. contour brush and go in and sniff my chocolate bronzer and contour really quick. So this is totally optional. I just like doing it because I like having my nose look a little bit slimmer. So now we're done with our face. Moving on to our eyes, I'm just gonna go on with the usual, the Urban Decay Primer. This is a brand new bottle or tube. All right, so that wasn't too bad. So today we're gonna focus on a really wearable look, nothing like my other tutorials, full of glitter and pinks and purples and greens and all that crazy stuff. I'm gonna stick to the safe stuff. So I'm gonna be using the Lorac Pro Palettes. We're gonna be going in with this brown color to start off, the light brown, just to, you know, start a transition shade. So this does not have to be precise at all. I'm just gonna sweep this across, you know, my crease and just do big old windshield wiper motions. So, super sloppy. Well, don't try to make it sloppy, but you know. Now I'm just gonna go in with this mocha color here, just with a dense brush, big flat brush. And we're just gonna put this all over the lid. This is just gonna be a nice lid color. And it's got a bit of sheen, so the light will pick it up. And it's just so pretty. I'm gonna go in with this light bronze and just put it in the inner half of my eye. Just to lighten it up a little bit. And that's not bright enough for me. So I'm gonna go and put just directly in the inner corner a little bit of this nude. Just to brighten it up. And it just really makes you look more awake too. I just love the effect of this. I'm gonna drag it underneath too. And drag it up. So there, it just kind of brightens up your inner corner. I just love the way this looks. And then lastly, we're just gonna go in with this pewter shade here, just to deepen up the outside just a teeny bit. We're not gonna smoke it out, I promise, but just like a nice day look. You just wanna darken it up a little bit, right? So we're gonna go with pewter and just darken out that outer corner. I'm gonna go on with a highlight. I'm gonna use that nude color again and just dust that above my brow bone, or on my brow bone, excuse me. So I'm just gonna use the NARS Via Veneto to tight line, which I just did, and then I'm also gonna put it in my waterline. There we go. And you can use this to put on your lash line too. I don't. I like using my Stila. Always have, always will. So we're gonna use my trusty Stila pen. It's kind of drying out, so we'll see how this goes. I'm just gonna put a tiny, tiny little flick of a cat eye because I just can't help myself. This is very, very long wearing. Like once it's on there and once it dries, it's not gonna bleed or smudge or transfer at all. The only thing to be careful about if you are a beginner with makeup, this is very unforgiving because like I said, once it dries, it is so hard to get off. I mean, you can't just like go in there and rub it off a little bit with your finger. You have to actually take it off, like take it completely off, which kind of sucks because this is like the last step of your eye makeup. So yeah, this is very great, but that's the only con I have to it. But hey, that's also a pro, so it's all good, right? So anyway, now we are completely done with that. Now we're gonna go on to the mascara. And of course, I'm gonna be using my favorite mascara, the Rimmel Lash Accelerator. Let me just show you, I'm gonna zoom in. I just wanna show you how great this works. So let me just curl my lashes real quick. And I'll just do one eye and just show you the difference with just this Rimmel mascara. Do you see the difference? It is just so great. And this is drugstore, guys. You can get this at Target at $7 or $8. I just love it so much. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do the rest of my, I'm gonna do the other side of my eye and then we'll move on. All right, you guys, so that is it. I just threw on that mascara and your look is basically finished now. All I'm gonna do is powder, just set everything again. If you're oily, this is necessary. If you're not oily, probably don't have to worry about it as much. I'm just gonna go on with Tarte Smooth Operator Powder. Just a little bit here, you can see it's in my cap. And I'm just gonna reset my T-zone because that is where the action is at. So the last step is just putting a setting spray on. And if you want your makeup to last all day, and I mean all day and the next day too, use this guy right here. This is Model in a Bottle. I think I mentioned it once or twice before, but just a couple sprays of this and your makeup is never going to come off. Like ever. It's actually kind of scary. Be careful though, sometimes the spray doesn't come out right, so I always do a test spray. I think I got a defective bottle. So just, you know, hold it far away and keep your eyes tightly closed. If it gets in your eyes, it hurts so bad. You have not experienced a pain like this if this gets in your eyes. So just close your eyes tight. Hold your breath, because it also smells very strong. And just fan your face like I am, or just wait. And after that final step of the setting spray, you are done. This face should last all day, because you got the moisturizer, the primer, you know, you have long-lasting foundation. Me, I use the Tarte Clay Amazonian clay foundation. You know, I had, you know, specifically long-lasting blushes, and that setting spray will lock it all in. Like, it'll lock it in. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you really like this video, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.